The most expensive one was like 1,600.
What'd he sell it for?
He kept two of them, which is the karambit and the flit knife. He sold the huntsman for like 1,600, and he sold one of the other ones. I think the gut knife, which wasn't worth very much, like it was only worth 20 bucks, but someone offered him like I think like 45 Ks for it, which is like 80 US dollars. And he just took the Ks instead, and then sold the Ks on the Steam marketplace, and then, you know, bought games.
Let me check. We'll do a status check here. Yeah, here's one.
We should get anchor the boats.
Wreck tugboat, but it's a wreck nonetheless.
Weapon unlock, tear gas.
That's always a fun weapon.
Because it does fucking nothing.
Yeah, shotguns and stuff will spawn on this thing in single player. Like pump actions.
Why though? It's a wreck that's been down here for ages.
Yeah, still, maybe they had shotguns on board, you know?
Harpoon gun or GTFO?
Remember anything the else? Vehicle power, a harpoon powered vehicle.
Like a sealed container, those fuckers wouldn't work. Unless it was an AK.
AK will work anywhere, anytime, even when the only thing left is the fucking firing chamber. Have you seen those images of like when the US militaries or PMCs have confiscated AKs that Nigerian pirates use in little dinghies? And there's no wood left, the trigger's like broken off, the whole thing's rusted to shit and it still fires accurately.
Well, Mikhail Kalashnikov was a very famed weapon designer for a reason. Hey! That shit ain't cool.
Oh shit!
What?
I don't know how I- oh, okay. Just-
I'll just set the next mark. Try not to get too close to the shore, because there's rocks. We could beach ourselves. Somewhere over here, and there's an underwater hatch that references Lost. It puts out a Morse code that says, "It's me, your cousin. Would you like to go bowling or something like that?"
Really?
Yeah, it's over here somewhere. We can stop right now. We might find it.
Nah. I don't like Lost anyway.
I'm not a big fan.
J.J. Abrams.
J.J. Umbreon.
Savior of Star Wars. It's okay. We'll save Star Wars. Oh, I saw, remember how he's like, remember that thing where it's like, that's not how the Force works that, Han says to Finn?
Yeah.
Someone redid that, but instead of Han Solo, it was like, George Lucas, and instead of Finn, it was, J.J. Abrams, and he's like, it's okay, I'll save the franchise. I'll make, like, a redo of Episode 4, and he's like, that's not how the franchise works. Anything closer in the meantime?
No, nothing on this map I'm looking at.
We're nearly there.
The ghost of Mount Gordo!
Mount Gord. Pumpkin patch.
Mount Gordo.
I thought there was a shark under the boat for a second, then I realized it was the shadow on the water. It's just past midday.
Whoa.
We went over a big wave. Let me know. It's shit.
Okay, it's deep here.
Very deep?
Pretty fucking deep, yeah.
Is it down there though?
I don't know what I'm looking for.
What are you looking for?
I don't know, it's not labeled, it's just a marker, like a colored circle. Yeah, I may have the position wrong.
Good job.
Move over here a little.
It's probably closer to the shore, yeah?
Yeah, there's a big cliff down here, so I don't think it's right here.
Probably on the edge of the cliff.
Yeah, it's just a steep drop off here. If I knew what I was looking for, it'd be a little more helpful.
I'll come look.
Oh, here it is, it's a wrecked tugboat. Bring the boat.
I'm already under the water with you.
Oh, it's right about where I'm at. It's a wrecked tugboat. There's a whole series of missions in single player where you have to dive down at wrecks underwater.
Oh yeah, that's a cool wreck. A lot of coral under the water. Oh, there's something over this way with me. What's that? Broken pier? Oh, just a rock. Just, like, the rock just happens to be textured in a long rectangle, so I was like, oh, that's something. Where the fuck did the boat go?
It's right here. Oh,
I swam underneath it.
Nagasaki dinghy boats. There's this guy on Steam who ports these really, really, really bad GTA models, and it pains me to look at them because he doesn't use bump maps or anything. He just uses a base texture, diffuse texture, and that's it. Doesn't do any fong, detail texture, bumps, any. And the welding on the vertexes, like, you can see gaps between them. There's smoothing errors. It just looks like chunky ass.
People don't care, though. That's the point.
Yeah, there's low fucking standard. I was having, you know that coast map I did that was on Workshop, the ancient one?
Yeah, would that combine, like, the three separate maps?
No, the Coast 07 one with the bridge.
Yeah.
Yeah, that one, I told somebody it was chunky ass, and he said I was fishing for compliments because it was a great... I was like, dude, raise your fucking standards. I bet you'd accept seconds, sloppy seconds from a trailer trash whore.
Hey, wouldn't you?
No. I have standards. They may be ridiculously high, but they're still standards nonetheless.
Can't be very high if your girlfriend's got four tits.
Okay, she's got four nipple... Okay, that's different. And they're not even full nipples, they're like partial nipples.
That doesn't make it much better.
Stay with the boat.
Yes, sir. We're out in deep water again. Want me to drive it closer to the shore? I'll just drive it closer to you. Does that sound good?
Yeah, just follow me around. Although, don't get directly above me so I can actually surface. Where are we? Where is this one at? There's no, like, coded chart on this thing. It just has a yellow star somewhere right above.
Oh, and the stars are really big and the map's really small, so it's hard to see exactly
where it
is. Yeah,
it's like someone scanned in a Prima guide.
That, I wouldn't put it past them.
It's not the GTA wiki, it's the GTA Myths wiki.
I bank my kish.
Dosh. Hello, I'm Mel Gibson.
Hello, love.
I'm Mel Gibson. Would you like to play my safari game?
I was about to say Mel Gibson.
Watch out for that one.
Adventure. God, what's that from again?
It's from Mel Gibson Safari 3 from Burnt Face Man.
That's right. I hate Burnt Face Man so much. I tried re-watching it was too cringy.
It's terrible, that's the best part of it. I think this might be the wrecked submarine location if I remember single player correctly. I probably don't.
You'd think someone would have documented it.
Well, I mean, the map is separate from the iconography, so I don't know exactly what's what.
Oh, that's weird brain coral.
What the fuck is that? Is that a rock, or is that something?
Is that a giant... What's the fuck's this giant yellow thing over this way?
Yellow
is
thing?
Is part of the island?
Oh, that's just coral or mold or
oh,
whatever.
Oh, it's moss, yeah.
Yeah, look for... It's probably down deeper. Hang on, I'm gonna put a rebreather on.
The boat's slowly getting drifted to shore.
Don't let it get to shore, I'll find it. You just do your thing.
Yep.
I know the wrecked submarine's up north somewhere, I just don't know exactly where.
Oh god, I rode the wave like 90% of the way to the boat.
I don't want to get too deep because crush depth is a bitch.
Crush is spleening. I wish like the current didn't actually push the boats so far. Cause that thing drifted hella fast. I'd like to find some calm water to put the boat, but there's nothing around the top here.
Yeah, there's no calm water in GTA. If there's calm water, it usually means it's about to be a big storm. It doesn't last very long.
Or you're on a mission where there's calm water, like the one heist with the aircraft carrier.
Even then, it's not very calm.
It's much calmer than this. Like, eventually the waves stop breaking and shit. That's just flat water. I think it's so it's easier to get to the aircraft carrier. See
what
anything?
No, not yet. I know there's something down here, I just can't find it. I remember being down here for nuclear waste collection.
Could it be out deeper, but to the drop-off?
It might be. Very well might be. I haven't gone very deep because I don't want to die.
Want me to come pick you up?
Hang on. I'm just keep driving. I'm gonna keep swimming.
Because if you run out of rebreathers, you're fucked.
I got 18 more.
I thought you could only have up to 5.
You can hold up to 20.
You could hold up to 5
armor, and now you can hold 10.
Ah.
Wait, is that it? Oh, I found it! Here it is, the wrecked submarine.
Coming. You should be able to get scuba gear.
You can in single player. It's part of certain missions.
Where is it?
Over here.
Oh yeah, I see it. That was much closer to the shore than I thought. So, American submarine or Jap?
I don't think either. I think Soviet.
The Soviets invade in this game? I don't remember.
See, it's got all of its missiles still in.
True that.
See, all the missiles are still inside.
Ah, why do all different submarines have to look exactly the same? Apart from the Swedish submarines, which are all square.
Huh?
I love when I dive and it instantly puts me back above water.
What?
I love when I dive and it puts me back above water. Wonder what could cause this kind of wreck.
I hate submarines. Just the look of them unnerves me.
Because you know that someone's going to be in a tin can with other people underwater.
Can you imagine the STDs that go around in those things?
Not to mention if you're in a nuclear power submarine, what the after effects could have on you.
I think the Navy makes you sign a form saying they're not like.
Wouldn't surprise me.
Okay, so that
those
was the.
Those things have some serious safety shit on them. But if anything fucking cracks, you might as well just shoot yourself if you have the opportunity.
Remember, I was watching a documentary on a British submarine a long time ago, and they had one since like the 80s. And they were documenting them while they were diving underwater and they were going to Africa for like an aid mission, and they'd replaced like all the, like for the mission, they'd replaced all the missile like storage and everything except one pod for like all the like food and shit that they're taking or whatever. And like during the mission while they're underwater, they were forced to surface in like off the African coast in bad territory because the the septic pipeline broke, and it was spewing shit all through, like, the main corridor of the submarine. And it was contaminating everything. And they had to tie it up with rags and, like, fucking raise the submarine to the surface, open up the hatches, manually shovel out the shit. Then one people had to get a fucking lifeboat, and they took the dinghy to shore to get a new PVC pipe, and they reinstalled the PVC pipe and, like, taped it back on to the bit that was cracked. And then, like, 2 weeks into the journey later, it cracks and breaks again. And then they're just like, fuck it. We're decommissioning the submarine, we're not having this issue. The captain was straight up like, do we replace the pipe? No, we decommissioned the submarine, it's too old, fuck it.
Didn't Britain get rid of their last aircraft carrier?
Yeah, they sold it.
Yeah, their naval presence.
No, we didn't sell it, we had it taken for deconstruction, and then we made two more. Really top of the line nuclear powered ones, and then we ran out of money and we didn't have any money left to put any aircraft at all on them because we got rid of the Harriers and no weapons.
That's right. I remember one of them, or was it a battleship, they invested like several billion into an experimental weapon that just ended up being like an insanely long range 9mm fucking, like, barrel. The barrel for it was like 24 inches long, and it was meant to, like, punch shit kilometers and kilometers away, and they spent billions on it, and they could only fly.
Dude, don't even get me fucking started on the F-35, alright?
Well, you see, if the thing is that those weapons are like hyper accurate, super high velocity, but any aircraft that gets caught within its range is dead. Nothing.
They were working on a laser here at one point on base. They built a big vacuum dome for the laser. Another wrecked plane, Scoot.
Ah, didn't know where to start.
Bring the dinghy over here if you want.
It's like, ships right now are like,
oh, wow,
they have,
yeah,
like, one gun on it.
Do what?
And like, they're like, all the others are like, anti-aircraft.
The US Navy has a railgun.
Well, didn't, like, the Nazis have, like, a ginormous, like, machine gun that needed, like, 10 different fucking railway tracks to move?
No, that wasn't a machine gun, that was an artillery gun, it was called Gustav.
Yeah, that's right.
It's Thomas the Tank Engine's grumpy German cousin.
Gustav the Angry Railway Gun. Oh, I've lost the boat.
Like, that weapon could flatten entire small cities in its own right.
Yeah, it flattened a whole city in Russia.
I wonder where they fired it from.
Far
away.
That'd be mobile.
Though, I remember they were like, it was costing them too much to keep flattening the land in front, because they could only, like, move it in a straight line, so they just picked, like, the path to do the most fuck-uppery from, like, the middle of Germany out to somewhere, and it was costing them